Now through April 22nd, the Yale Institute of Sacred Music in New Haven is presenting a new exhibit. It is called Incarnations, Black Spiritualities in American Art. It features diverse works that reflect black spirituality, religion, and community. Here now to tell us more is Horace Ballard, the exhibit's associate guest curator. Welcome.
Good morning, Annie.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you very much for having me.
So first of all, just the very basics, tell us what you can see if you go to this exhibit.
Very wonderful. Well, this exhibit ranges a vast diversity of artworks. 29 artists, 38 artworks, watercolors, mixed medias, lino cuts, and everything in between. It's absolutely fantastic.
Sounds great.
And it's a beautiful, beautiful exhibit. And just as you said, deals loosely with the themes of community, religious devotion, and ethnicity, ranging over a 71-year period. The earliest work made in 1971, The latest work done as late as 2008.
And 29 artists from all over the country?
All over the country, yes, indeed. In fact, one of the pieces we have is from a place kind of in the backyard of New Haven in New York City, mm-hmm. from Dr. Deborah Willis, who is the chair of photography and imaging at New York University. And that's one of the pieces that is highlighted in the show and also on the brochure. It's her view from the pulpit, Eatonville, Florida.
Interesting.
Wonderful piece.
Now, is this a traveling exhibit that you guys were able to get to come here?
The Yale Institute of Sacred Music has wonderful relationships with other art museums and also art cultural centers across the country, mm-hmm. but we have a very special and very proud of our relationship with the David C. Driskell Center at the University of Maryland, mm-hmm. and also the Jean and Robert E. Steele collections.
Oh,
and so most of these works come from Maryland, from the Jean and Robert E. Steele collection and their association with the University of Maryland, the David C. Driskell Center.
Interesting. So now talk a little bit about black spirituality. Why is this such an important part of the black history in America?
Sure. I think that as early as, say, after emancipation, mm-hmm. Church life, devotional life, spiritual life has been one of the touchstones and cornerstones of not only just African American history, but American history in mm-hmm. general. And then going into the mid-20th century with the Civil Rights Movement, mm-hmm. we realized that church communities were really instrumental in helping people register to vote, helping people
Absolutely.
Fight for their rights. And so this exhibit is really kind of paying homage to that history,
mm-hmm.
and really thinking about the multiple ways that black artists and also American artists in general have thought about issues of religious devotion and spiritualism in kind of this growing age of the 21st century.
I have to say, I generally think of it as expressing itself more in music, such as gospel and the amazing, you know, history there, than I really do in art, in the visual arts.
Sure. David C. Driskell, who had a distinguished career as a professor at the University of Maryland for over 30 years, often says that African-American art really is the cornerstone of history, and that this history has expressed itself in music, just as you were saying, and we rarely sometimes imagine that spiritualism will play out in the secular arts, but they mm-hmm. truly, truly do. This piece that we're looking at right here on the screen, it was actually done by Professor Driskell in 1986, mm. Spirits Watching, after a few trips that he took to Ghana. And so we see him as the son of a preacher down in rural Appalachia in western North Carolina, really reflecting on his own interpretation and experiences and memories from his father's pulpit and days of his being
see,
in his father's church
more reminiscent
with
of,
his African
right,
travels.
Of the masks and the
exactly.
And the spiritual. So it's a mixing of
the two. Yes, indeed. And this is the image we talked about briefly, mm-hmm. View from the Pulpit, Eatonville, Florida, by Dr. Willis. It's a color photograph done in 2003, reprinted in 2008. Really, I think, giving many of us a view that we often don't have
mm-hmm.
of a congregation from the pulpit. And you can see here the beautiful stained glass windows mm-hmm. in the church. So kind of bringing all of these colors together and talking about the theatricality and the staging
mm-hmm.
of preaching, but also the joy.
Interesting. Gets a little tease there. All right, well, if you're interested in going, it sounds absolutely fascinating. Yale Institute of Sacred Music at the Divinity School there on Prospect Street. Weekdays 9 to 4 and nothing on the weekends, just the weekdays.
That's the time that it's open, yes,
okay.
indeed.
And now through April 22nd, so you still have time to get over there and check all of that out. really sounds very interesting. And of course, there's 29 artists, 30 pieces of work, so a lot more than what we just showed you.
Yes, indeed.
Great. Thank you so much, Horace.
Thank you very much for having us.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Steve, over to you.